Welcome class 8 student. This is chemistry class, class 8 chemistry, and this is chapter 1. Title of the chapter is matter. Students, as you can recall, during last session we were talking about solid, liquid and gaseous state. Now three gaseous state, solid state and liquid state are not only the confined state. In later classes you will come to know that there are actually five states, but in class 8, class 7 or up to class 10 we are bothered about only class of solid class, liquid class and gaseous class. We also know that interconversion of matter also takes place. Let me show you this picture. Now as you can see the movement of my cursor on left hand side of the screen. Class, please pay attention to this figure 1.4, and this is interconversion of a state of matter. Now solid can change to liquid state, liquid to gas, gas again on cooling back to liquid, and it is solid. Now this interconversion of state of matter has certain terms. Let us see what these terms are. First term is melting or fusion. As we can see in the figure, melting is here. Melting means change of solid to liquid. Second thing is evaporation. Change of liquid to gas is evaporation. Similarly, opposite, gas back to liquid is condensation. This is triggered by cooling. Again, liquid can be freezed to get solid state. This is called solidification. Now there are a specific point of temperature where these conversion takes place. First is melting point. Now melting point is a temperature when melting occurs. Now melting occurs in solid to liquid state. So the temperature that is fixed when solid changes to liquid is called its melting point. Different substances have different melting point in their pure state. Students, please pay attention to my words, because if a substance is not pure, melting point will differ. In later session we will check how it changes. For example, melting point of ice is 0°C. Similarly, for evaporation there is a boiling point. Now look at the cursor left hand side of your screen. Boiling point is a fixed temperature when liquid starts to change into gaseous state. All the temperatures are fixed for a particular thing, and if the substance is pure, it will always be constant. If impurities are melted or mixed in certain type of substances, all the points of temperature will change. Again, for condensation. Condensation, look here, condensation is a change of gas to liquid. Condensation, gas to liquid. So condensation point is a temperature when the gaseous state changes to liquid state. Second point is a freezing point. Freezing point, you can see here, freezing, change of state from liquid to solid. So freezing point is the same change. Freezing point is a temperature when liquid start to change to solid state. Now coming to next point is law of conservation of mass. Lavoisier actually proposed the law of conservation of mass. He proposed that matter can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. Matter can only change from one state to another state. However, change of state takes place in chemical process. Now this law of conservation of mass can be also stated that in a chemical reaction, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. It means there is no change in mass. In practical application, when you weigh or measure a volume or mass, you will see certainly change. But if there is a decrease or increase in mass, then it implies that the product has changed its state. If you take an example of activity 5, We can see activity 5, left hand side of your screen. Things required are conical flask, 10 ml tube, 2 measuring cylinders, thread, cork, the balance for measuring the mass, barium chloride, that is BaCl2, and sodium sulfate solution, that is Na2SO4. Now, experimental verification of law of conservation of mass. Students, let us see what it says. Take 5 ml of sodium sulfate solution in measuring cylinder and pour some in a conical flask. Take 5 ml of a barium chloride solution in another measuring cylinder and pour it into a test tube. Tie the test tube with a thread and hang it in the beaker. You can see here, this is test tube and this is the thread. This is the test tube and this is the thread. Now put a cork in the mouth of a test tube so that all the things or all the materials are safe there. Carefully weigh the weight of conical flask and now tilt and twist the flask so that the barium chloride mixes with sodium sulfate solution. After some time you will see reaction starts and now there is a white insoluble precipitate. Sodium sulfate is converted to sodium chloride and barium chloride converted to sodium sulfate. Now again take the measurement of mass. You will observe the total mass of apparatus plus reactant is equal to total mass of apparatus plus product. If you cancel the apparatus here and if you cancel the apparatus here, let us see again from here and from here, we will see that mass of reactant is equal to mass of product. It verifies the law of conservation of mass. It means there is no change in mass of reactant and product. Let us see the activity number 6, how chemical and physical change take place. Things required: plastic bag with a zip lock, vinegar, baking soda and a balance. Take some baking soda on a paper. Take 1/4 cup of vinegar in plastic bag. Weigh them separately. Let us assume some variables for that. Let the mass of plastic bag and vinegar plus baking soda plus paper be W gram. W is a variable. Now carefully put the baking soda with a paper in a plastic bag and lock the zip immediately. You can see this figure. You can see this figure. All the arrangements are done here. Now we quickly zip the apparatus or setup so as to no gas escapes. After the reaction start, a strong effervescence or fizz sound occurs indicating the formation of carbon dioxide gas. Wait till all the fizz sound disappears. Now, if all the fizz sound disappears, it means chemical reaction is complete. Again, wet the plastic bag, you will see it comes to W gram. It also proves that in a chemical reaction or in a chemical change, the mass of reactant is equal to mass of product. The reaction is given here, NaHCO3, that is baking soda, acetic acid gives out carbon dioxide, sodium acetate and water. Now why there certain precautions are taken? Students, please pay attention to right hand side of your screen. Now if you are not careful enough or not zipping the bag here, the desired result is not obtained. Now when wood is burnt in air, ash is formed. If you wet the ash, you will find that weight of ash is different from weight of wood because during burning time some gas escape and hence there is a change in mass of the product. Similarly, when magnesium ribbon is burnt, a white solid is obtained and the mass of reactant is different from mass of product. Why? Because this magnesium combines with this oxygen and magnesium oxide is formed. Hence, the weight is different. Students, this is the conclusion of this experiment. Hence, you can see on your screen, we come to the end of the chapter. There are some points which are to be revised. I am supplying the PDF version of this chapter to you at the link. Please follow the link. And if you have any doubt, if you have any comment, you can write your comments in the box below the video. Please pause the video, play it again and again, and you can check your progress, how you are getting the points. If you have any questions, please write the comment. I will surely address your concerns. Now let us take these points for revision. And students, I think you are very comfortable with chapter, because this chapter was not only the basic foundation, it was only the revision of what we have studied in class 6, class 5 and other class 7. So students, please revise your syllabus, and best of luck for this chapter 1.